The show trial in New York is not the only assault on our Constitution and way of life. It isn't just President Trump and his inner circle who are targets of a socialist Democrat party that has abandoned our mutual compact. Far from it. Every day, Americans are being persecuted by a radical left-wing system that's being weaponized against them. Take the case of Dexter Taylor in New York. This is a story we first brought you a few weeks ago. Brooklyn man, no criminal history, who was targeted for exercising his constitutionally protected Second Amendment rights. His crime? Assembling so-called ghost guns as a hobby. Perfectly legal under U.S. law. Taylor was raided by police and arrested in 2022. This week, he was sentenced to serve, get this, folks, more than a decade behind bars. Joining us now is Vino Varghese, Dexter Taylor's attorney. Taylor is unable to join us, of course, because he's serving his sentence at New York's notorious Rikers Island. It's good to see you, Counselor. When we last spoke, you didn't sound like you had a lot of confidence in New York's justice system. I got to tell you, I don't either. What was your client found guilty of, first off, remind the folks, and isn't the sentence insanely high?
So let me take that backwards, Chris, and thank you for having me on and bringing this to your audience's attention. The sentence is insanely high. It was nearly three times the minimum sentence for what he was convicted of. He was convicted of basically a paperwork crime. Had he had applied for a license, he would have been immunized from prosecution for most of the counts. He was convicted of 13 counts. Most of them had to do with building his own firearms in his home, things that he bought parts legally online. And what happened was that the ATF tracks purchases around the country, but they don't have the resources to prosecute. They don't have the law to prosecute the purchase of manufacturing. So what they do is share that intelligence with local law enforcement around the country in states like New York. And in this case, they shared that intelligence with the NYPD, and then the NYPD and ATF together, if you watch the video, they're on together, raided his home, broke into his home. And at no point, you see this exchange of them breaking in. And Dexter's like, hey, who are you looking for? This is Dexter Taylor's apartment. Believing that and understanding that under the Second Amendment, under the United States Constitution, he broke no law. The judge in the case was the toughest prosecutor in the room, forbid us from making arguments. I mean, I was telling you this as we were starting the trial. She told us the Second Amendment didn't exist in her courtroom. And, you know, we knew Dexter was going to get convicted. Dexter knew he was going to get convicted. Wow. And yet, when he was ultimately convicted, he was gracious. He was gracious to everybody. He told me his mother was in the courtroom upset, started crying. And he told me, as Jesus did to the Apostle John from the cross, said, you know, take care of my mother. So that's who Dexter is. And at sentencing, he was gracious. And the judge, right before sentencing him, was whining about how she was criticized on social media. I mean, she would have been better off not saying anything.
You know, these people sound like a bunch of goose-stepping Nazis. I'm sorry, they just do. You know, it's my understanding that Americans have the right to produce their own firearms as long as those guns are not for sale, as long as they're not there producing them for sale. The last I checked, this is still the United States of America. First off, how is this happening? And what are the next steps for your client?
So the reason that it's happening is after 2022 and the United States Supreme Court found New York's licensing regime unconstitutional. New York basically, you know, told the United States Supreme Court, we're not going to listen to you, and basically came up with a system that very much mirrored the old system. Before, you had to show just cause to get a firearm in New York, and which is controlled by the NYPD. They get to decide who gets a firearm within the city of New York. And to something called, and you'll appreciate this, Chris, good moral character. So think about it. The state of New York, the city of New York, and the NYPD get to decide if you or I are of good moral character. And they had a guy on from the Licensing Bureau to talk about it, and I tried to get him to explain what that meant. He couldn't. He had no answer. He was it was a joke.
The entire damn state is unconstitutional. The entire state of New York is unconstitutional. I don't even know how this is permitted in the United States of America. Look, last thing, I only got about 30 seconds left, Counselor. How's Dexter holding up? Are you able to talk with him?
Yeah, he calls me almost every day, checking in. He spends more time calling his family. He's doing great. He thanked all the court officers. He thanked even the prosecution for being his worthy adversary when he was sentenced. He gave that a speech before sentence. That's the stuff of legend, Chris. I sent it over to your staff. I hope you get a chance to look at it. It's something spectacular.
You know, I appreciate you bringing this to our attention. Please keep us posted. Let us know if there's anything we can do to highlight what I view as corruption in the state of New York. For those who say, oh, yes, you know what? The Second Amendment doesn't exist in New York. Oh, really? I didn't know that was your call. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it, Counselor.